kind of have this wine mom, wine wife type of culture where if we don't get something perfect and we feel like a failure, we just think that it's not worth doing at all. Hello, lovely feminine women, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for being here, thank you for watching my face, and thank you for contributing to the slow but steady growth of this community. If you happen to stumble upon my channel, please consider joining our community of feminine women who also like to talk about homemaking. Before we start, I really encourage you to hit the like button on this video because it helps reach more women and it overall helps kind of propel this type of femininity revolution that is happening on the internet. I was very hesitant to film a video today. I was actually going to skip it, but these are the times where I feel like my message, what I'm going to talk to you about, some more sticky subjects really need to reach somebody out there. So if this video helped you in any way, or if you have something to add to the conversation, a personal anecdotal experience or a perspective that could benefit another viewer, please comment down below. By the end of the video, my goal is that you are going to have some tools in your toolbox to deal with a sense of failure. And you're also going to be able to reframe your failure as it pertains to your femininity and your homemaking. So without further ado, let's get into the first point, which is acknowledging failure and kind of understanding failure in today's society. We live in a hyper-driven culture where being the best is paramount, where being the best is assumed to be the most important priority. This is detrimental, and I want you to begin acknowledging that because it impedes your femininity, just this fact in itself, because it prevents us from building collaborative relationships with other people and nurturing the connections that we already have. It also causes us to not feel appreciation for the things that we are accomplishing ourselves because we kind of tend to carry around a sense of being second best, of being a runner up. We don't take the time to show gratitude, which is a feminine trait, for the things that we have already accomplished. I also think that many of us are dealing with the feelings of jealousy and we're dealing with feelings of competition and social media comparison. I've made two videos on this that I'm going to link down below that I highly encourage that you watch after you watch this video. In order to really live a fulfilling life as a feminine homemaker, I honestly believe that we need to put aside our tendency to compete with other people. And we need to understand that we are doing these things to improve ourselves as an individual, and especially if you are a Christian woman, as I always say, this applies to other faiths as well, I just don't know, but we are doing the things that we do for the glory of God. I feel somewhat qualified to talk about this topic because I myself have dealt with this throughout my life. I was always very intelligent, but I was not the most intelligent. I was always very good at pageants, but I was often not the best at them. I was very good at sports, but I was not the best to make that most competitive team. Instead of dwelling on shortcomings, one of the ways that I overcame this was I acknowledged the fact that being second best or being a runner-up really isn't something to be sad about at all, but it is actually something to rejoice in because you put the effort in to try. You might be feeling this in your plight to develop as a feminine woman or as an excellent homemaker because you might find yourself not quite measuring up. You might do a homemaking task and you might feel proud of yourself initially, but you might fall perhaps in the trap of social media comparison. Instead of feeling like what you accomplished is not worth anything at all, try to reframe your thinking and to tell yourself that it is okay that you perhaps did that same homemaking task as somebody else and yours didn't turn out as good. Do pat yourself on the back and be proud of yourself for trying anyway. This leads me into my next point, which is normalizing failure. Especially in today's society, it goes back to that concept, we have a hard time talking about perhaps our potential pitfalls. People often only talk about failure when they've accomplished something great after it. We seldom hear about the time when somebody might have failed at something or failed at something over and over again, and perhaps it didn't exactly result in the best potential outcome. But I also want you to think about it from this perspective. If you find yourself completely, for example, failing at feminine dressing, or you feel that way, or you are failing at a homemaking making task like cleaning. Instead of focusing on continuously doing that over and over again and expecting that perhaps after the 10th time you're going to reach that perfect state, try to look at every time you do try a feminine principle or a homemaking task and how that caused you to learn something in the process. The next thing I want you to do is to actually look at how you can gain control of your failure. There are things that we do in life that are mistakes because we are sinners after all, but there are things that we can actually fix when we do them. We can actually diffuse the situation and make things better. Instead of dwelling on a failure or something that you might have done wrong, try to look at it from an objective perspective as asking yourself if there is something that you can do to make it better. I also find that for many of us, we have a fear of being judged because we have a fear of failure, which causes for us to not try feminine goals or to not try homemaking goals. I'm going to tell you a little bit of a story. When I was doing modeling, I would also get sent on acting jobs. When I would get sent on acting jobs, you guys, this is why when people come on my channel and they tell me that I copy other content creators, that I basically just laugh. Because I am a really, really bad actress, like extremely bad. Like I would go into these modeling jobs, these acting interviews that I could not say no to, because if you say no to the casting calls that your agency sends you on, they're going to be less prone to give you work. And I would embarrass myself to the point where the people watching the auditions would give me a number of an acting coach or would kindly tell me that this was not meant for me. That being said, I'm not telling you that you should give up on trying on your femininity goal. I did not give up on acting, but what I found instead was a different part and a different place to put my potential acting, which ended up being infomercials and show modeling, where I had to act and show off a product. Instead of focusing on that one specific thing that you're trying to do over and over again to reach a type of extreme goal, try perhaps reorienting your efforts in your femininity and homemaking. This brings me into my wider topic, which is the scope. You have to perhaps narrow your scope of the things in which you're trying to accomplish. For example, homemaking for the purpose of having a perfect home. If you have many people who live in your home, you might not be able to ever achieve the level of cleanliness that you desire that is magazine worth it. Instead of obsessing over techniques that you can do in order to get that state of perfection, try to reframe your thinking and reorient your direction to a different scope. For example, cleanliness for functionality in your home rather than cleanliness for magazine perfection decor. Feminine dressing instead of trying to attract your future husband, and you might be asking, why is he not here? I am dressing femininely every single day. Perhaps reorient your scope to feminine dressing to be able to cultivate a more bubbly personality, which will eventually probably attract the right person in your life. And the final broad topic I want to talk to you about is self-responsibility and motivation. I want you to focus on your motivation for homemaking and femininity, again, rather than the end result. I want you to cultivate personal integrity. In our culture today, we kind of have a lot of this like wine mom, wine what? We kind of have this wine mom, wine wife type of culture where if we don't get something perfect and we feel like a failure, we just think that it's not worth doing at all. This comes back to my point about God. Who are you doing it for? You should be living your life for the glory of God. And if that is something that you do not believe in, I want you to think about the process, going back to the process. What can you learn from the process of attempting something rather than fixating on the failure? What are your intentions behind what you're trying to accomplish? If your intention behind what you're trying to accomplish is selfish personal gain, there also might be something said there for the fact that you are failing. Goals based on personal greed or personal gain tend not to get us very far because they are very superficial. They do not last long and they tend to lead us into failure because they are not something that we can cultivate our morals and our values on. So I want you to think about why you want to apply feminine principles and why you want to become a good homemaker in certain respects. Are you doing these things for the right reasons? I'd love to know your thoughts down below on how you deal with failure, what you have done in the past, what you plan on doing, because perhaps this video might not be something that is so popular. It might not be a hot topic, but I do really feel like this video was intended for somebody out there. So if they come onto this video and they watch it, it might be even 3 months down the road, and they see your lovely comments down below or some of your personal experiences, I really think that it could help another woman. And at the end of the day, speaking of purpose, that really is why I'm here. I'm not raking in the dough making these videos. I am just here because I care about you and I envision a future of many feminine women that uplift each other. See you next time. Bye-bye.